So welcome. Now, the first topic is it good to be a perfectionist? Are you a perfectionist? Do you think that perfecting things or looking for a perfection is a good thing in life? Or do you think that no, I don't have to be a perfectionist? I want you to think about it. Many people say it with proud, I am a perfectionist, I want to perfect things, I have certain standards. It's good thing to try to do your best things. But perfection is a destination for which you require a long journey. And if you think you would do things only when they are perfect, then probably you would hold yourself to do many things in life. So again, ask yourself, am I trying to be a perfectionist? Because some of the indications will tell you with clarity that am I a perfectionist or not. For example, if you are waiting for the best conditions to apply your learning or trying to learn something, I will speak in English when I speak perfectly, else I would not speak. I will start my YouTube channel and I'll speak in front of a camera only when I know things perfectly, else I would not do. I will make my first public speech only when I know perfectly. I'll start my business only when I know things perfectly, else I would not start. If you are the one who thinks of perfecting things, then please realize you may be wasting so much of your energy in waiting for things to get perfect. My appeal to all of you is stop being a perfectionist in your approach. Start where you are. You don't have to be a perfectionist in everything. Companies like Google, companies like Apple, they start new projects, pumping billions of dollars into it, and it fails. Even they have not perfected things. So if you think that you will do things only when they are perfected, you would keep waiting. In fact, this would become your excuse to not take challenges. This perfectionist mindset is somewhere reeks of a fixed mindset. There are two kinds of mindsets. There's a book written by Carol Dweck called Mindset. And these two kind of mindsets are what? The first one is called fixed mindset and the second one is called a growth mindset. A growth mindset person starts where he or she is presently. So it really doesn't matter where you stand today in your public speaking, in your book writing, in your ability to deliver a talk, or in your business. It really doesn't matter. What matters is, are you ready to adopt and learn things? Because if you are a perfectionist, you are waiting for ideal time, for ideal people, for ideal resources, for ideal situation to begin. My friends, you are wasting a lot of your time in making things ideal. They would never be ideal. I remember when I got into public speaking, when I became a professional speaker, in initial days, I used to spend so much time in designing a small brochure, in finalizing a card design. But soon I realized, I have to start wherever I am and I have to keep on improving from here. If I keep on waiting for perfecting things, I'll waste a disproportionate time in things which is not going to help me. Find me one person who has perfected everything and who has never committed mistake. One actor. Actors like Amitabh Bachchan, like Dilip Kumar, or like whatever Khans you like, anyone. Have they not given flop movies? Have they not acted badly in many movies? Is there anyone who has never given a bad performance? Even though they try to perfect things, there will be wrong things. Please realize, take away this burden of being perfect in everything from day one. Yes, you can aim for being your best. Nothing wrong in that. Because I am not suggesting that become comfortable in being mediocre. No, that's not the suggestion. My suggestion is, if you are holding yourself from doing things because they are not yet perfect, you are committing a big mistake. We don't have a very long life. This 70, 80 years will go in a jiffy. What we need is explore life to the fullest. Because in the end, we should not have this feeling that, oh, I kept on waiting for too long for perfecting the things, but that was never there. We need to understand this one thing, that no matter where I am today, I will start from there a little bit. I know so many people, they are waiting for perfect situation to start their health routine. They are waiting for their dieting plan to be perfected by somebody very experienced. They are waiting for their Nike shoes or some special t-shirt or maybe a gymnasium at their home before they start working out. That's the problem with perfection. I'm not trying to say that you should not aim to become the best. My appeal is, if you are waiting for everything to become ideal before starting things, then that's not a good strategy. Please re-look at it. Start where you are. Tomorrow onwards, you can start your morning walk without waiting for all those things to come. Tomorrow onwards, you can start with one push-up. You can start writing one paragraph. You can start making one-minute video. You can start making one sales call. Whatever is your area of work, please don't wait for situations to be ideal so that you can go. No, that's going to hurt you badly, because you will spend a lot of time in perfecting things. With every day, if you plan for progress, that's a better strategy. It's well established fact that aim for progress, don't aim for perfection. People who aim for perfection, they find it difficult to adjust with people, because they find nooks in everything. You will not even be comfortable with someone who is not like you. We become a control freak where we try to do everything ourselves because we want things as we want. That's what a perfectionist happens. They find problem even in finding a life partner. So they keep on delaying their marriage because they are waiting for some perfect partner. Please remember, there is nothing called perfect partner. It will never happen. You have to start thing and you have to make them perfect. And even then, they are not going to be perfect. Have you seen a perfect father, a perfect teacher, a perfect son, a perfect child? No, none. There is nothing called perfect. Yes, we can aim for making things best. But please don't wait for making things perfect. Another part of this comes is, when people try to compete against each other, they get into this orientation, which I call performance orientation. When they want to beat someone else, and they think, until I become like that, I'm not good enough. It's important in our life to stay happy, then become an achiever. Yes, you should try to achieve. Yes, you should try to do your best. Nothing wrong in that. But please do not aim this at the cost of stagnation in your life. Stagnation, you know, when you're waiting for things to get perfect, don't wait. So many people are waiting for somebody to give them a call for their job. They're sitting at home and waiting. Somebody will give me a call because I have applied on Naukri.com, on XYZ.com. I have applied and now I'm waiting for a call. Don't wait. There is nothing called a perfect job. There is nothing called a perfect boss. Things are always in the gray area in reality, in practical life. So my appeal to all of you is, start wherever you are. Don't wait. If you are a teacher and if you want to start something online, this is the time. Don't wait. Don't wait for Corona to get over. Don't wait for somebody to give you a nod. Wherever you are, please start. And today, technology is giving you the chance. Today you have access to some of the best of the resources with this cloud computing, 4G internet, broadband internet. You have this. Please don't wait for the perfect time. If you are an organization, please don't wait for the perfect time. Start things, start experimenting, keep moving. Look for progress. Perfection will happen on the way, but look for progress. Is Apple a perfect product? Don't you have issues with that? Don't you have that big in between a dent for your face recognition which takes away the beauty of it? There will always be something or others in other in life. So please stop waiting for perfection. You will disproportionately waste your time and resources in one thing. Aim for your best and keep growing. That's called growth mindset. Now coming to the second point, and please hold on your comments, okay? Hold on to your comments. Coming to the second point is in Hindi about this worrying, chinta. And the topic is, kahin chinta aapki aadat to nahi hai. इज वरिंग योर हैबिट? जब छोटे थे तो पढ़ाई की चिंता, थोड़े बड़े हुए तो नौकरी की चिंता, करियर की चिंता, नौकरी लगी तो प्रमोशन की चिंता, पैसे की चिंता, शादी हो गई तो घर की चिंता, और थोड़ा आगे चले गए अपना बिजनेस कर लिया तो बिजनेस की चिंता। अब अगर जब वृद्धावस्था में आ गए हो, व्हेन यू आर ग्रोन ओल्ड, तब बच्चों की चिंता, चिंता कहीं आपकी आदत तो नहीं है, कभी भूतकाल की तो कभी भविष्य की, कभी पैसा नहीं होने की तो कभी पैसा अधिक होने की, इस पैसे को संभालो कैसे, और किसी के पास ज़्यादा है तो पैसा बांटने की चिंता, कहीं चिंता आपकी आदत तो नहीं है, इज वरिंग योर हैबिट? बिकॉज आई हैव सीन सम पीपल आर इन इटर्नल वरिंग मोड, दे जस्ट फाइंड न्यू रीजन, कोरोना इज द लेटेस्ट रीजन दे आर इन वरी, बट माइट इवन इफ देर वॉज नो कोरोना दे वर वरीड When they had 1 lakh rupee salary, they were worried. When they are earning 5 lakh rupee a month, they are worrying. And even if they are earning 50 lakh rupee a month, they are worrying. Because their worry is not coming from outside world. It has become their habit. Sometimes they are worrying for kabhi man ki chinta, kabhi tan ki chinta, kabhi dhan ki chinta, bachchon ki chinta. Chinta aapki aadat to nahi hai. Please think about it. If you are living like in life in eternal worries, look at the people. आपके साथ में ऐसे कुछ लोग होंगे जो चिंता नहीं करते, मस्त राम है. Have they done badly in their life? Just have a look. क्या उन्होंने जिंदगी नहीं जी? क्योंकि बहुत सारे लोग ऐसे होते हैं जो बुढ़ापे में ये सोचते हैं, जिंदगी में कुछ मिला नहीं मिला वो बड़ी बात है, जिंदगी जी या नहीं, पता चला जी नहीं, जिंदगी निकल गई, कभी किसी की चिंता तो कभी किसी की चिंता. प्लीज़ रियलाइज, डोंट मेक वरी योर हैबिट. लाइफ इज नेवर गोइंग टू बी परफेक्ट, देयर विल ऑलवेज बी सम और अदर चैलेंज. व्हेन योर चैलेंजेस आर ओवर, योर किड्स चैलेंजेस विल कम. व्हेन एजुकेशन चैलेंज इज ओवर, चैलेंज रिलेटेड टू करियर विल कम. इफ दैट इज ओवर, मे बी इन द मैरिज देर आर सम इश्यूज. व्हेन दैट इज ओवर, मे बी समथिंग एल्स विथ योर किड्स, समथिंग एल्स विथ योर सोसाइटी. These things will go on. Please don't make worrying a habit. It's not about corona. It's not about money. It's not about your education. It's not even about your career. It's a habit which you have developed. So if you are into eternal worry, I want you to re-look at your life. कहीं चिंता आपकी आदत तो नहीं है? आपको सिर्फ कारण चाहिए. Please see. You have some meaning in life. Please see that you are enjoying your life. Please revisit your childhood questions which you might not have discovered even today. Please revisit them. In childhood, when you thought, how did this moon come? How are these stars hanging there? How winter and summer and rain happens? All these curiosities of child, have you really quenched them? Your thirst of these curiosities? Are you actually living? Or you are just stuck in day-to-day mundane thing? Please see, चिंता आपकी आदत तो नहीं है, कहीं चिंता आपकी आदत तो नहीं है. So these two very important facts I just wanted to discuss, because I have seen these two kind of people, and for last few days somehow they have come to my in my contact little too often. I have seen few people are eternal worrying, few people are always waiting. For 4 years they have same problem. They're talking only about problem for last 4 years because they have start liking to talk about problem. They cannot find anything worth gratifying in their life. I don't know why. Itna kuch Bhagwan ne diya hai, kabhi uska dhanyavad kiya hai? If you have a healthy body, you need to say thank you. 20 crore children sleep hungry in our country. 20 crore log roj bhuke sote hai, bacche. एक टाइम का दूध नहीं मिलता है. अगर आपको खाने में जो आप चाहे वो मिल रहा है, यू शुड बी थैंकफुल. जस्ट रिविजिट. मेरे किसी दोस्त ने एक पिक्सल फ़ोन लिया. ही वॉज सो हैप्पी विद द कैमरा. ही सेंट मी सम शॉर्ट्स एंड सोट. सी विवेक, व्हाट पिक्चर्स, व्हाट ए क्वालिटी. हाउ मच वी चेरिश अ पीस ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. a mobile phone camera, a picture, yes, you should enjoy. But how about these eyes? Have you ever really cherished kitna megapixel ka camera hai? Since childhood, it's recording every scene of your life in the best possible resolution. I don't know, when was the last you told, wow, what are eyes? This heart, I hope all of you have that, right? This heart, which is pumping, you know how many times? On an average, 1 lakh time every day. When did this machine lub dub, lub dub, lub dub? When did this start? When we were not even born. And when will it stop? After 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 years of age, have you seen any machine which works non-stop for 70 to 80 to 90 years? Have you seen any such machine? I don't know how many of us have told, wow, what a piece of technology here. Thank you. I don't know. When did we say great about this? Your small kidney, which is filtering your blood every moment, including now. When was the last time you told, wow, what a great piece of technology. See how it is filtering my blood, flushing out all which is not required and remain keeping all the things which are essential. Two kidneys. Jiska kidney kharab ho gaya, usko poochho. For him, what matters in life is kidney. But we have it. Because it is free, we don't cherish it. There is no sense of gratitude. Because chinta aadat ban gayi hai. Ya to perfect karne ki, ya koi karan dhoondne ki. Please see. Please revisit. This time will go in a flash. I can just see how my childhood till now, how it has just happened in a flash. If I just revisit, it looks like moments, it has gone. Life is not too long, not too... There is no time to waste for this. Yes, I'm not telling don't be cautious. You know one interesting fact? Our lower brain, the brain which is primitive in nature, what you call, it has the function for survival. Happiness is not the function of lower brain. You know, it wants us to keep alive. So it's always about fight and flight mode. Either it is scared or it wants to fight. Because it's always in survival mode. If you are in constant worrying mode, if you are into constant thankless condition, if you are driving your life only out of your fear, you are living out of your lower mind, mind with lower faculties, primitive mind. You have not even started using the human gift. Very important to express gratitude. Vivek sir, it is easy to talk about gratitude. You should see at my life. If you have a healthy body, if you are looking at this video, there is enough for you to say thank you. If you are living in a country like India, you have a reason to say thank you. Because we could have been born in Somalia, somewhere in Syria, so many such countries. We could have been born there. Luckily, we are not. And mind you, we have not done anything great for getting all those things. So the point is, express gratitude. Stop worrying. Start working. Don't worry about perfection. Perfection will happen. It's a destination. But your journey will start out of non-perfection. No one in this world has perfected things. Michael Schumacher lived his entire life, lived in style, right? One of the most dangerous, risky game, Formula One car, where many people have died like Ayrton Senna. He completes a successful career, almost picture perfect completion, and then gets into an accident somewhere skiing and now in the bed for last many years. Can you guarantee perfection for anything? There is no such thing. So my humble suggestion to all of you is, whether you are successful or you are a failure in some ways, or you are still in the process, whether you have money or don't have money, worrying doesn't help you in any way. And expressing gratitude is a must part of it. If we are a human being born in a country like India, if you have your family, if you have enough to eat, if you have enough clothes to wear, if you have some education, if you have a healthy body, that is enough to say thank you. And why should we say thank you? Because if you say thank you understand the gifts of life, therefore you cherish it. Otherwise, you won't cherish it. You won't cherish it. Warren Buffett may have billions of crores of rupees or dollars. But many of you who are in your 20s and 30s, you have that next 50 years in your kitty, which he doesn't have, and he cannot buy even 1 year of that. I want you to realize, are you really hopeful, enthused about that? Are you expressing gratitude for that? If you are not expressing gratitude for these simple things, you will fail to appreciate things which later on come in your life. It could be a bungalow, a big car, lot of money, bank balance, name, fame. I don't think you'll be able to enjoy that, because worrying would have become a habit. Come out of perfection disease, come out of worrying problem. Move on in the life, express gratitude. That's my message today. Thank you so much for listening to me. Now I will read your comments. Thank you so much for being here at 11:37. Without an announcement, I started live, just 15 minutes notice I gave, and so many of you are here. Thank you so much. I really appreciate your love, affection and support. I'll read your comments now. Narendra ji, hi. Rocking Ram, hi. YK Bhaiya, Naveen Kishore, Gupala, hi everyone. If you are there, give me a thumbs up, give me a thumbs up. Thumbs up karo bhai. Yes, ab koi prashna hai, if you have any question, feel free to ask. Telugu sir, please don't delete your live session. We can watch if we miss it. Okay, I'll not delete it, News Hub. How to become a good public speaker? Public speech dena shuru karo. Start by telling stories to young kids and record yourself and see how do you speak. Okay? Take training, coaching. Learn from the people who know this art. Learn from the internet. There are so many ways. But start. Okay? Remember my message. Don't wait for perfect day. Start tomorrow. Get 3-4 kids around you. Tell them a story. That will be your first public speech. Yes? Narendra Kapoor. Sir, I always very high. How can I come out of it? You can come out of it by expressing gratitude. Please express gratitude for the greatest gifts of the life. Look around you. There are so many people for whom the life you are living is a dream life. I'm repeating. There are so many people for whom the life you are living is a dream life. I remember in one orphanage when I went, this is long back, one child was so happy because that morning he got in his breakfast doodh jalebi. And for that he was expressing gratitude in the classroom. What he ate at 8 a.m. he was happy for that at 12 p.m. For a lot of us, that is not a habit, right? Family responsibility, no excuses, family responsibility making it delayed. Still trying hard, but my responsibility keep on adding. I am unable to come out. Hanukant ji, see, we have responsibility, all of us. There is nobody who doesn't have a responsibility. Keep moving slow and steady. Keep adding your skills. One very important aspect is add skills. Skills, adding skills in self, that will give you many years advantage. It will take your career ahead by many years. And collaborate with people. So I understand there are responsibilities, and it's good that you understand your responsibility and you are taking it. But communicate well, collaborate with people, seek help and invest in your skills. That will take you ahead. Okay? Slow and steady. Don't worry about it. Fluent English, I have made already so many videos. Please see them and start applying. Don't wait. Start applying. My question to all those who are asking questions about English, my question to them is, what steps have you taken till now? What are you waiting for? Have you started collecting sentences? Have you started speaking in English irrespective of people making your fun? Have you started practicing them every day? If you have not started, there is no point in waiting. I don't know, what are you waiting for? Best strategy, perfect strategy, the best book, the best teacher? I have a news for you. There is nothing called best. Any mentorship program? Yes, I do provide a mentorship. There is a 3-month mentorship program called Grow Up Growth Boost Bundle, Growth Booster Bundle. Okay. So I'm presently mentoring 10 people, 9 every day and 1 offline I'm mentoring. So there is a mentoring program called Growth Booster Bundle. If you are interested, send me a mail. I will send you the details. The mail ID is connect@drvivekmodi.com. Okay, Karthik, News Hub Telugu. Sometimes your passion is not your profession. Yes, so for that, what you need to do, either whatever your profession is, if you're not in the position to give that up, then learn to love your profession, whatever it is, okay? Little bit of effort, you'll be able to do it. And if you don't find a love or don't start liking your work any which way, even after trying, then start looking for a new profession. There are only two ways, okay? Both are valid and both are correct. How to love it? By getting involved into it. We don't love things when normally we don't calibrate them properly. Okay? Start improving, make a conscious goal, find a meaning in that. Now, I cannot tell you in so brief, but you can always do things. You know, people who start having alcohol addicts, even alcohol they don't like in the beginning, but they go on to become addicts later on. If you try something in a conscious way, if you make a small goal and achieve that, that will give you thrust to like that thing. That will make you feel that yes, I can also do it. Sometimes what happens when you don't have a feeling, when you have that hopeless feeling, when you are working without a meaning, that time you don't like the work. So find a meaning, give yourself a reason. Even if you want to work for everyone on the earth, you are included into that. So please see that you don't get into this mode that I want to do social service. You do your social service, but first enable yourself, okay? Without standing on your own leg, without helping yourself, if you try to help everyone, I don't think it's going to work for long. Yes, you are also part of all. So please see that you respect yourself. Okay, so quite some time, almost 30 minutes have gone by. Thank you so much. Think about these couple of things which I shared, a very frank, without actually thinking much. I was just having this feeling to share with the YouTube family that stop worrying, no matter what is the challenge, stop worrying. Worrying is not going to help you. And stop waiting for perfect time, perfect situation. Stop waiting for perfection. Okay. Start things and look for continuous, deliberate practice and continuous progress. Even if it is a small progress, but if you do it consistently, continuously, you will achieve whatever you are looking for. Now, I cannot give you any medical advice here. So about schizophrenia or autism, daughter, please, I'm not an expert to give an advice here online. It's not even, the right thing to do. So sorry, Hari Gandhiji, Hari Gandhi, right? I am not able to do it. Okay, so wish you all a very good weekend. Good night. Good night, good night, good night. Thank you so much for being here at late night with such a short notice. Good night, everyone. Have a great weekend.